Good morning, students. Today we will discuss trapezes of page number 212 and area of parallelogram. See children, trapezes of page number 212. Question number 1. Find area of parallelograms. And this figure is given to us. See, this is the figure of parallelogram. Here, this side length is 8 cm and this length of altitude or height of the parallelogram is given to us. Here height of the parallelogram is 3.5 cm is given. And this is the base. And we know that parallelograms opposite sides are equal in length. So this side, opposite side is this side. So this side length is 8 cm. Then this side length is also 8 cm. Because in parallelogram, opposite side length are equal. So this side length is 8 cm. So its opposite side is this and its length is also 8 cm. Now this is the base of the parallelogram. So base B is equal to 8 cm. So B is equal to 8 cm. And this is the height of the parallelogram. And its length is 3.5 cm. Height means H. So H is equal to 3.5 cm. Now we have base of the parallelogram and height of the parallelogram and we have to identify area of the parallelogram. We know the formula to identify area of the parallelogram. Area of the parallelogram is equal to base multiply height. Area of the parallelogram is equal to B multiply H. Here B is equal to 8 cm. So instead of B, we can write 8. Multiply, then multiply. H means height and H is equal to 3.5 cm. So instead of H, we can write 3.5. Now 8 multiply 3.5, its answer is 28. And unit is centimeter. So 28 cm square. So area of parallelogram is equal to 28 cm square. Now question number 2. In a parallelogram ABCD, AB is equal to 7.2 cm and perpendicular from C on AB is 4.5 cm and we have to identify area of parallelogram ABCD. So first we will draw parallelogram ABCD. Already I drawn parallelogram ABCD. And perpendicular from C on AB is 4.5 cm. So this is the perpendicular, see. This is the perpendicular from C on AB and its length is 4.5 cm. So AB is the base of the parallelogram ABCD and CK is the height or altitude of the parallelogram ABCD because it is perpendicular. So here 90 degree angle formed. So CK is the height or altitude of the parallelogram. Now base AB is equal to 7.2 cm. See, this is AB is the base and AB is the base and its length is 7.2 cm. So base AB is equal to 7.2 cm. And CK is the height or altitude of the parallelogram and its length is 4.5 cm. So CK is the 4.5 cm. Now we have base and height of the parallelogram ABCD. So we can easily identify area of the parallelogram ABCD. We know the formula to identify area of the parallelogram. Area of the parallelogram is equal to B multiply H. So area of the parallelogram is equal to B. B is equal to what? 7.2 cm. So we can write 7.2. This multiply then multiply. H means H means height. And height of the parallelogram is 4.5 cm. So 7.2 multiply 4.5. So area is equal to 7.2 multiply 4.2. Its answer is 7.2 multiply 4.5. Its answer is 32.40 cm. 32.40 सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर. सो फाइनल आंसर एरिया ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम एबीसीडी इज इक्वल टू 32.40 सेंटीमीटर बिकॉज इट्स बेस इज 7.2 सेंटीमीटर एंड इट्स हाइट इज 4.5 सेंटीमीटर. सो फाइनल आंसर एरिया ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम एबीसीडी इज इक्वल टू 32.40 सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस एरिया ऑफ ट्राइंगल. टू डिस्कस एरिया ऑफ ट्राइंगल फर्स्ट वी विल कंसिडर वन पैरेललोग्राम एंड देन वी विल ड्रॉ वन डायगोनल. See here, consider parallelogram ABCD and draw diagonal DB. So see here, this is the parallelogram ABCD and one diagonal DB I drawn. Consider parallelogram ABCD and one diagonal DB we drawn. See here, this is the parallelogram ABCD and one diagonal DB we drawn. If we draw diagonal DB, then in parallelogram ABCD, there are two triangles. See, this is the triangle 1 and this is the triangle 2. See, this is the triangle 1, triangle ABD, and this is the triangle 2. See, triangle BDC. So, triangle ABD and triangle BDC. If in parallelogram ABCD, if we draw diagonal DB, then inside the parallelogram, there are two triangles, triangle ABD and triangle BCD. And see children, triangle 1 and triangle 2, both are congruent to each other. Triangle 1 and triangle 2, both are congruent to each other. See, AB and BC side length are same. BC and AB side length are same. And this DB is the common side of both triangles. So triangle 1 and triangle 2 both are congruent to each other. So area of each triangle is equal to 1 half multiply area of parallelogram. See, this is the total area of the parallelogram. And inside of the parallelogram, there are two congruent triangles. So, area of the parallelogram we can divide by 2. So, area of each triangle is equal to 1 half multiply area of parallelogram. And we know the formula to identify area of the parallelogram. See here, 1 half multiply area of the parallelogram formula is what? B multiply H. B multiply H. So, formula to identify area of triangle is 1 half multiply B multiply H, where B is the base of the triangle and H is the height of the triangle. Area of the triangle is equal to 1 half multiply B multiply H. This is the final formula to identify area of the triangle. So area of triangle is equal to 1 half multiply B multiply H, where B is the base of the triangle and H is the height of the triangle. Now this formula I can explain with the help of the different figure. See children, consider the following triangle. Figure number 1, triangle ABC. See, this is the triangle ABC and we know the formula to identify area of the triangle. Area of the triangle is equal to 1 half multiply B multiply H. 1 half multiply B multiply H. So see children, this BC is the base of the triangle ABC. BC is the base of the triangle ABC and AN, this AN is the perpendicular drawn from point A to BC at point N. So AN is the height of the triangle, or we can say that altitude of the triangle. So 1 half multiply B multiply H is the final formula to identify area of the triangle. So area is equal to 1 half. B means base of the triangle. So BC is the base of the triangle. So instead of B, we can write BC. This multiply then multiply. H means height of the triangle. And height of the triangle is what? AN. So instead of H, we can write AN. So area of triangle ABC is equal to 1/2 multiply base multiply h. Here base B is equal to BC, so BC multiply then multiply, and altitude is AN, so height or altitude both are same, so height is equal to AN. Now second figure. In second figure, triangle PQR is given to us, and QX is the height. QX is the height or altitude of the triangle, and PR is the base of the triangle. Here this PR is the base of the triangle, and QX is the height or altitude of the triangle. So area of triangle is equal to 1/2 multiply B multiply H, already we identified. So area is equal to 1/2 multiply base. Here base is what? PR. So we can write PR multiply then multiply, and height. Height of the triangle is what? QX. QX is the height of the triangle. So PR multiply 1/2 multiply PR multiply QX. So area is equal to 1/2 multiply PR multiply QX, where PR is the base and QX is the height of the triangle. Now third figure. In third figure, triangle ABC is given to us, and it is right angle triangle. We know the formula of the area of the triangle, 1/2 multiply B multiply H. So area is equal to 1/2 multiply B multiply H, where B is the base. So here BC is the base, and this AB is the altitude or height of the triangle. So area of the triangle is equal to this 1/2 multiply, B means base, so BC is the base, then multiply, and height is what? AB. So AB is the height of the triangle. So area of triangle is equal to 1/2 multiply B multiply H, where B is the base and H is the height. Here base is BC, so instead of B we can write BC, multiply, and H means height. Here height is AB, so instead of H we can write AB. So area of triangle ABC is equal to 1/2 multiply BC multiply AB. So this is the explanation of trapezius of page number 212 and area of triangle. What is the formula to identify area of triangle? Area of triangle is equal to base multiply height, where B is the base of the triangle and H is height or altitude of the triangle. I hope you can understand this. Thank you.